to protect you. Let's talk about this, shall we? Getting your children to tidy up their bedrooms. Well, it's not happening in my house, I can tell you. Make your bed up, boy. It's only a quilt. All you need to do is spread it and put the teddy on there. Well, it's a real bugbear for lots of us parents, isn't it? A song created by two teachers from North London is tackling the problem head on. The Tidy Up Rumba, yes, that's what it's called, has become so popular in classrooms all over the world, it's been listened to by more than 2 million people.
Pick up the pens, put them in the pots, don't forget the lids, we'll put them back on. Oh, they will dry up in a week and not draw those wonderful, wonderful pictures.
I think I meant shake, 2 million
shake,
times.
Shake it till you drop. Shake it, shake it, stop. Don't do the belly flop. It's fun when we shake.
I think I could have that. With George Papakouriakou and Chris Michael are the teachers who came up with the song. Well, I start with you, George.
Hello there. Hi.
Hamming it up. Is that
say
what
that
it's
again?
Hamming it up in that song.
Hamming
is that,
it up.
Is that what you were doing there, sir?
We were having a laugh. We were having a really good time, yeah.
Well, where's the idea come from then?
Well, we just, as we were recording our album, we thought, what else could we write about? And we thought, you know, a tidy up is quite an issue for children. So we thought that that's a great little number to get recorded and then have a bit of fun with.
And how surprised are you by the reaction and the number of times it's been viewed?
It's just absolutely awesome. It's mind-blowing. It's unbelievable, really. It's just... it's wonderful just to see people using it in their classrooms and children raving about it and teachers raving about it. So it's wonderful. I feel really blessed to be able to be in this position, actually.
Yeah. Well, Chris, come and talk to me. A new idea then, something that's catchy, that rhymes with silly actions and big characters. A children's book next, I reckon. What do you say, Chris?
We've done that already. We've done that already. It's all ready to go. So, and that, yeah, it's not a lie. We'd love to. We've always been sort of, we had a chance to work together, luckily, some years back. So we, also being good friends, it was just kind of like a recipe that worked, really. So we're just at the end of the school day getting together, having a laugh. And lots of songs have sort of come out of it. But this one in particular has been pretty special.
What is it about it, do you think?
Oh, I'd love to be able to know that because I'd write another 10. And some of my friends say, well, why don't you write another 10 rumbas? And I don't think we can ever do that again. I don't know how we can. I just think it's perhaps the essence of that real fun factor, that being silly, people kind of second guessing, are we Mexican, are we Spanish, are we putting it on, are we not? And I think it's just the silliness of it. I think it's just the pure silliness and having a bit of a laugh.
Who's enjoying it more, the parents, the teachers, or the children themselves?
I think the children are probably our first and best fans, and then our teachers have been so amazingly supportive. We've been really lucky. We've, you know, teachers are using it. We're getting fantastic feedback. I've got lots of friends that are teachers, as has George, and so the song is being used and sort of carried around and recommended. And so it's, but I think the kids, yeah, definitely the kids. The kids, you see that energy in them, and it's addictive. It's amazing.
George, help me. What ages are we aiming this at? Because there's some big kids who listen to Drive Time in their 40s who could probably do with listening to this, I imagine.
I like it. Maybe from 4-year-olds to, I mean, 4 to 9. But the thing is, I've had YouTube comments coming to me saying that we're in year 7 and year 8, and which is like 11, 12-year-olds. And they say to me that, you know, their teachers put that on for them to tidy up to. So I don't know. I don't think there's a limit to the age group here, really, to be honest.
Yeah, but Chris is right. I mean, you're on to something here now. And now, while we've got the momentum, because this team of three of us, right? I'm putting myself in there. We've got the momentum. How are we going to keep this thing going? Have you done it live, George?
Not really. I mean, today in the classroom, I've done it live. Occasionally sung it in with the children in my classes that I teach, but I haven't really done a live performance of this song.
Oh, Chris, we've got to do this live, haven't we?
We're on tour, 100%.
Yeah, yes, oh yeah, it'd be great fun. We're going to dress him up as a clown, aren't
yes.
we? Is that what, big nose?
A big Mexican with a big sombrero and on a donkey.
There you go. It's gonna be, look, can I just say, look, sometimes we talk about tough stories and...
Yeah,
it's a fantastic thing, and when we're talking about teachers, it's about how hard it is as a profession. And but lovely, well done to both
Thank
of you,
so much.
And look after yourselves, George and Chris. That nice doing a good news story, eh? You know how I have to fight to do a good news story on this show. Oh. Now look. going to go and Google that now. See if I can get my children to listen to it. That's going to be the. Can you get it on iTunes? Do you think? Yeah, you must be able to. I just get it. Or can I just take the version that you played? Because I haven't got any money. No. Okay, sorry. It's called the Tidy Up Rumba. By the way, more of your messages here. Would you leave your children alone? Rachel says, not in a million years.